Hi everyone, I'm Colleen and this is Adam.
Hello.
And we're talking about great ways to reduce back pain in pregnant clients.
So in your pregnant clients, especially as a baby grows, it's going to start to shift the spine and the pelvis, so it's going to put a lot of pressure on that low back. I'm sure you've heard the complaints already. So today we're going to just talk about a couple things that you can do or have your clients do that hopefully will diminish that back pressure or eliminate it altogether. Enjoy. Okay, so we're going to go through this quick circuit. The circuit will be done one time through, and then they're ready to jump in their normal warm-up. The first thing we want to do is kind of reduce any spasm or some of the compression issues from that spine. We'll start with the first one is kind of a semi-aggressive one. You always want to be gentle with this, and then we'll give a little bit of break-off. So the first one is basically hanging traction. So I grab on, you have rings, and I'm slowly going to squat down. I still have a good active shoulder in this, and then I can move my feet depending where I want this traction. I'm usually going to start at about a squat, and then I'm just going to slowly kind of breathe and just start to relax my abdomen and let that spine kind of droop. All right, I'm trying to maintain alignment, or my feet slightly in front, that'll keep it sort of slightly tucked, and that'll take some of the pressure off. You'll do deep breath for about 15 seconds. Then you're gonna slowly engage and then start to come up. All right, you don't wanna jump right out of it, just nice and easy, and you'll repeat that two more times. So again, hands on the rings. I'm putting the pressure on my arms. I'm slowly gonna go into this position. I'll shift, and then from here, then I'm just gonna deep belly breaths and let that spine and pelvis elongate. And then gently get up. We just don't want that stretch in the spine to like shove back together.
So. All right, now we're gonna move on to cat-cow. Whenever you have your client starting in cat-cow, make sure they're going through really gentle ranges of motion, nothing too extreme, like a really deep dip in cow position, and nothing too crazy in cat. Yeah. So a great way to make this a little more controlled and focused for your clients is to start really activating glutes and obliques when they're in that cat position. It's a great way to focus on breath, activate those lower abdominals, and really relieve the pressures of the lower back region. After cat-cow, you can move into a hip flexor stretch. Clients are going to be on bended knee, untucked toe here. You're going to squeeze butt cheek of that bended knee, posterior tilt of the pelvis, really elongating that front hip flexor, and then they can start to gently lean forward and really feel a nice, good stretch. And then big belly breaths. How's that feel?
I feel it. Stretching. All right, and for the last part, we're gonna put two movements together. So we started to create traction to kind of alleviate some of the pain and compression. Then we went through some gentle motion, getting a little bit of activation. Then we opened up the hip. And now we're gonna continue to open that hip up by using and activating the posterior hip, okay? So Colleen is gonna go ahead. She's gonna think about this. Kind of activating, just like we said, the lower abdominals, obliques, and then a little bit of glute and hamstring at the end position. If you feel like your butt comes off a little bit, that's fine. If they have a history of disc issues, or the posterior kind of shooting of that disc, then you would not have them exaggerate that quite as much. But ideally, you want to make sure that we're having a good abdominal contraction here, and the glutes engage as well. And so that's going to really help the hip flexors open up, and help their posture through the movement. Now, being CrossFitters, we've been exposed to the hollow body, and if they're very, very strong, they can start to go ahead and lengthen out your feet. Good. And so she's gonna tuck her feet together, point her toes. So now we're gonna make this more of a gymnastics kind of blend, and she's gonna create this hollow position, which is that same posterior tilt, and then she can start to lift up her heels just a little bit. If she can't do it, that's fine. Even in that lengthened position, as long as she's working on that posterior tilt, this will be a good kind of segue or maintenance of those skills. So once she's gone through and done this, she's going to go ahead, she's going to flip over gently. And so we've created a lot of motion, a lot of activation, and hopefully a little bit more opening in that front of that hip. So now what we're going to do is, she's going to go through cat and cow again real quick, and then we're just reestablishing her end ranges of her spine. Boom, yep, there's that club butt, and then she's going to come up back, meow, big cat, yeah. So now I'm going to bring her back into that neutral. Cool, now we're going to bring in that breathing technique, so big belly breath, engage through here. Good, so now she should have this corset on through her whole torso, and now she's going to go opposite leg and arm and extend. Good. And so you'll feel a lot of time, the Colleen's got a tight hip flexor too, that this will rotate or this will drop a little bit. So you're just trying to cue in. Then she can come in, she doesn't have to touch. Good, she doesn't have to touch there, but if she wants to. What we're really just trying to do is bring back that coordination of that movement and throughout the lumbopelvic region. Bonus, big words, right? Okay. Cool, and she'll switch sides. And then she can hold up here. If you find you're working with a client that really is kind of strong too, you can test in, see what their air, you can push them a little bit, just see where their breath is at.
Great, well, we hope you enjoyed the movements that we demonstrated and you have success with your pregnant clients.
Yeah, so go through, make sure you're, even though we give you this template, make sure you're touching with your clients and just that it's not too aggressive. Always kind of build into it, especially if their back is really touchy. We'll have a slide on after this, so you'll be able to reference that stuff. Like she said, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to add them to the video.
Thank you.
Have a good one.